गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर साइंस ओलंपियड सिलेबस. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस. ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फोर सेशन, ऑलरेडी वी हैव कंप्लीटेड फोर सेशंस ऑफ योर साइंस ओलंपियड एग्जामिनेशन सिलेबस, साइंस ओलंपियड चैप्टर्स, ऑल दोज थिंग्स ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. आई होप all of you have gone through all the videos yet. Who have not gone through yet, please go through as early as possible, because these kinds of examination is very much important for your future, and these kinds of question is also very important for your science olympiad examination. So I hope already all of you have gone through all the videos. So let's start the today's class. Today's topic is physical and chemical changes. Before starting the topic, you must know one thing, that what is the basic definition of physical and chemical changes. What is the basic definition of physical and chemical changes? So what is the basic definition of this thing? The basic definition of these physical things means the it's actually these changes is actually temporary. What does it mean? It means the suppose the water is converted to ice. Okay, so this is one physical change. What is the meaning of it? It means that you can transform ice to water by melting the ice. Okay, or you can convert water to ice by freezing the water. So this is actually the physical change. So now I am going to discuss what is the meaning of the chemical change. Chemical change means the permanent change. It means the when you are mixing magnesium plus sulfate, then it's formed the magnesium sulfate. So this is actually the chemical changes. Why? Because you cannot reverse back this MgSO4 to sulfur or to magnesium. So this is the basic things of the physical and chemical changes. This is the basic things of the physical and chemical changes. Okay. Next thing is the what is the basic difference between the physical and chemical changes? What is the basic definition or what is the basic difference of the physical and chemical changes? The basic difference between the physical and chemical changes that it's actually the physical change is actually the temporary change and the chemical change is actually the permanent change. Okay, so let's start the first question. The question number one is read the given statements and select the correct option. The statement 1, in a pressure kerosene stove, both physical and chemical changes take place. And in statement 2, in a pressure kerosene stove, first we pump kerosene to convert it into vapors and then vapors are ignited. Okay. So, which is the correct answer? Option A, both statement 1 and 2 are true, and statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. Option B, both statements 1 and 2 are true, but statement 2 is not the correct explanation of statement 1. Option C, statement 1 is true but statement 2 is false. And option D, both statements 1 and 2 are false. So option A will be the answer. Both statements 1 and 2 are true and statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. Why? Because conversion of kerosene to its vapor involve changes in the state, that the liquid state to the vapor state, and no new substance is formed. So it is a physical change, and during the time of ignition of the vapors, a lot of heat is actually given out and new substances are formed. Therefore it is a chemical change. Next question, which of the following statement is correct about the given changes? The first is the beating aluminium to make aluminium foil. Next, cutting a log of wood into pieces. Next, heating an iron nail till red hot. Next, crystallization of pure copper sulfate crystals form an impure sample. So, which is the correct answer? The correct answer is option C. All are physical changes. Why? Because all the given changes are physical changes as no new substance is formed. As no new substance is formed. So, this is the basic things of the chemical changes, that in the chemical changes a new substance will form, but in the physical changes there will be no new substance will form. Okay. Next, question number 3. Vishakha took few wire pieces made up of different metals and placed them in blue solution of copper sulfate. What will be the color of the solutions present in beakers 1, 2 and 3 after half an hour? Okay. So, which is the correct answer? Option C is the correct answer. That for 1, this will be green, for 2, this will be blue and for 3, this will be blue. Next, select the incorrect statements. First statement is hydrogen gas turns lime water milky. Option 2, both rust formation and ice formation are chemical changes. Next, both melting of butter and melting of wax are physical changes. Next, mixing of milk and curd produces a chemical change. So, which is the correct answer? Option C is the correct answer, that 1 and 2 only. Why? Because carbon dioxide gas turns lime water milky and ice formation is a physical change. Why ice formation is a physical change? Because after when the ice become melt, then it transfer to the water instantly. Okay. Question number 5. Study the given experimental setups 1 and 2 and select the correct observation. Just look at the experimental 1 setup. This is the calcium carbonate. This is the hydrochloric acid. Calcium carbonate means the CaCO3. Hydrochloric acid. CaCO3. This is the calcium carbonate. Okay. And hydrochloric acid means the HCl. Okay. Next is the zinc, and this is also the hydrochloric acid. Zinc means the for Zn. Okay. So for option A, the gas coming out from the test tube 1 turns lime water milky. Next, the gas coming out from test tube 2 turns lime water milky. Next, the gases coming out from both the test tubes turn lime water milky, and the last of all, none of this. Okay, so which is the correct answer for question number 5? Option A is the correct answer, because when the carbon dioxide gas turns lime water milky and ice formation is a physical change. Okay, when CaCO3 plus HCl turn CaCl2 calcium chloride plus CO2 plus H2O. Okay. Then carbon dioxide gas turns lime water milky. Okay. And hydrogen gas does not turn lime water milky. Okay. Next is the question number 6. Observe the given reaction sequence carefully. That the acetic acid plus sodium hydrogen carbonate to sodium acetate plus water plus 1 dash plus CO2 dash 2 plus water. So, which is the correct answer for question number 6? C is the correct answer. For 1, this will be CO2, and for 2, this will be CaCO3. Question number 7. The ash which is collected after burning of magnesium ribbon is dissolved in water to give a solution X. What is the nature of the solution X when it is tested with indicators? Option A, it turns blue litmus red and phenolphthalein pink. Hence, it's an acidic solution. Next, it turns red litmus blue and phenolphthalein pink. Hence, it is a basic solution. Next, it turns blue litmus red and gives no color with phenolphthalein. Hence, it is an acidic solution. And option D, it does not change color of red or blue litmus and phenolphthalein. Hence, it is a neutral solution. For question number 7, which is the correct answer? Option B. It turns red litmus blue and phenolphthalein pink. Hence, it is a basic solution. Question number 8. While performing an activity in lab, Russell dissolved sugar in water and observed the change. His friend Sobit took a little sugar in a spatula and directly heated it on a Bunsen burner flame, change 2. Which of the following is correct regarding change 1 and 2? So, statement 1, change 1 is a physical change. Option 2, a new substance is formed during change 2. Option 3, changes 1 and 2 both are reversible. Option 4, change 1 is reversible while change 2 is irreversible. So, for question number 8, which is the correct answer? Option C is the correct answer. Okay, that dissolving sugar in water is a physical reversible change. When sugar is heated, it decomposes into carbon and water. Okay, next, question number 9. Read the following statements and state true or false. A molecule is formed only when two or more similar atoms combine together. Option 2, a compound is formed by combination of two or more elements. 3, a compound can be broken into simpler elements by simple physical methods. And 4, an element contains only one kind of atoms. For question number 9, C is the correct option. That for statement 1, it will be false. For statement 2, it will be true. For option 3, it will be false. And for statement 4, it will be true. Question number 10. Study the given figure carefully. Okay. So, which of the following reactions explains the above change most appropriately? So, for question number 10, which is the correct answer? Option B is correct answer, that CuSO4 plus Fe. CuSO4 means the copper sulfate, Fe means the iron. When you are mixing copper sulfate with the iron, then it will change ferrous sulfate plus copper, FeSO4 plus copper. Okay. For question number 11, which of the following will lead to a chemical change? Statement 1, making a fruit salad and keeping it in the open air for 1 hour. Heating of calcium carbonate, making paper boards by cutting paper, and next, keeping an iron nail in moist air for a few days. So, for question number 11, which is the correct answer? Option D is the correct answer, that fruit salad when kept in open air turns brown due to reaction with air, and hence a chemical changes take place. Calcium carbonate on heating decomposes into the calcium oxide. And this carbon dioxide, which is a chemical change, iron nails when kept in moist air undergo the rusting. For question number 12, which of the following do not represent that a chemical change is taking place? A gas is produced, precipitate is formed, state of substance changes, a new order is produced, shape of a substance changes. Okay, so for question number 12, D is the correct answer, the 3 and 4 only, that change in state or shape of a substance is a physical change, because that's not the permanent change, it's actually the temporary change. For question number 13, observe the given reaction carefully and fill in the blanks by selecting an appropriate option. Fe plus CuSO4, it converted to FeSO4 plus Cu. So, before reaction, iron is dash in color and solution is dash in color. After reaction, iron gets dash deposits and the solution becomes dash in color. Okay. So for question number 13, which is the correct answer? Option C is the correct answer. That for 1, it will be gray. For 2, that before reaction, iron is gray in color and solution is blue in color. But after reaction, iron gets brown deposits. And that's called the rust actually, and the solution becomes green in color. Question number 14. Observe the given experimental setup carefully. In which test tube rusting of iron nails will not take place? For question number 14, which is the correct answer? Option A is the correct answer. For question number 15. Kunal took few iron turnings and mixed them well with sulfur powder. He could separate the iron turnings with the help of a magnet. He heated the mixture for some time and tried to separate the iron turnings with the magnet, but he could not. Why? The first option is, on heating a chemical change takes place and a new compound is formed. Option B, on heating iron becomes non-magnetic, hence it is not attracted by magnet. Option C, on heating a physical change takes place, hence iron and sulfur gets mixed up. And option D, on heating iron evaporates and only sulfur is left behind. For question number 15, which is the correct answer? On heating a chemical change takes place and a new compound is formed. Okay, that the Fe plus S FeS. FeS means the iron sulfide. FeS means the iron sulfide. That iron and sulfur. When you add these two components with the help of the heat, then it's transformed to the FeS. Next question number 16. Some hot questions are there. All those kinds of questions are very important for your Olympiad examination, because already we have discussed this Olympiad examination is actually one national level examination. So question paper standard also will be high. So please be prepare yourself. Okay. On that manner. For question number 16 is, observe the given figure carefully and identify the substances marked as P, Q and R. So for P, it will be zinc, Q, water, R, carbon dioxide. Okay. Next is the, for P, it will be magnesium, Q, hydrochloric acid, R, oxygen. For P, next, magnesium, Q, water, R, carbon dioxide. And last, for P, zinc, Q, hydrochloric acid, R, hydrogen. So, which is the correct answer? That option D. Study the given Venn diagram carefully. Study the given Venn diagram carefully. Okay. Next is the, both statements 1 and, okay. Next question is the, identify 1, 2 and 3. So, melting of ice, rusting of iron, cutting a log of wood. Okay. Next, glowing of bulb, bursting of tire, crystallization. Next, switching of garments, burning a matchstick and burning of a candle. Next, melting of ice, decomposition of sugar. Next, sublimation. Okay, so which is the correct answer for question number 17? C is the correct answer. Okay. For question number 18, that Rupali classified a few changes occurring around us as shown in the table. The grinding of wheat, bursting of crackers, formation of clouds, germination of seeds, drying of wet clothes. So, which of our observations are incorrect? For question number 18, which is the correct answer? Option C is correct answer, that 1, 4 and 5 is incorrect. 1, 4 and 5 is incorrect. Why? Because grinding of wheat is chemical, not physical, not reversible. This is actually the physical change. Okay. Okay, next is the germination of seeds. It's actually C as written, chemical, not physical, reversible. Okay, drying of wet clothes. It's actually chemical, C as written, physical and reversible. ओके. फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 19, रीड द गिवन स्टेटमेंट्स एंड सिलेक्ट द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. स्टेटमेंट 1, मेनी कट फ्रूट्स व्हेन केप्ट इन ओपन टर्न ब्राउन. स्टेटमेंट 2, ब्राउन ऑफ फ्रूट्स इज ड्यू टू अ केमिकल रिएक्शन. सो विच इज द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 19, दैट बोथ स्टेटमेंट्स 1 एंड 2 आर ट्रू एंड स्टेटमेंट 2 इज द करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ स्टेटमेंट 1. लास्ट क्वेश्चन from this chapter, that during the science activity, Miss Prover demonstrated an experiment in following steps. Step 1, she burned a substance X over the candle flame and white dazzling light was observed. Also, white powdery ash was left behind. Step 2, she mixed the white ash formed with small amount of water. Then she dipped red and blue litmus papers into the solution one by one. Which of the following statements are correct? That the substance burned in step 1 was magnesium, the white ash formed in step 1 was magnesium oxide, the solution formed in step 2 was acidic in nature, and the solution formed in step 2 turned blue litmus red. For question number 20, option A is the correct answer, that 1 and 2 only. The substance burned in step 1 was magnesium, okay, and the white ash formed in step 1 was magnesium oxide. Okay, so this is your actually the last question from this chapter. In our next video, we'll discuss our next chapter. I hope this video will help you a lot for better understanding. So go through it properly. If any queries are there, just ask me. It's not like that all those questions only will come in your Science Olympiad examination, but this type of question may come in your Science Olympiad examination. So you can take it that just like the sample question paper. Okay. So just go through it, go through your NCERT books properly, study your NCERT book properly, then you can take help from any other reference books and then go through these kinds of videos. I think all those things will help you a lot for better preparation. Okay, thank you. Bye.